The first section of the train that derailed at Wallen is back on track and about to head slowly north to Sydney after a successful lifting operation. But the mangled front locomotive still remains on its side and could take days to remove. Lana Murphy reports.
Winched from the edge of the railway, 100 tonnes of steel is righted onto the track. The rear power car and one of five passenger carriages of the derailed XPT, guided by cranes, into position, ready to make the slow journey back to Sydney more than 3 days after it departed for a routine Melbourne trip. It's the first step in recovering the vehicle after the crash that killed veteran driver John Kennedy and his pilot on Thursday night. The train going off the rails at a passing loop with 153 passengers on board.
Part of the process to move the locomotive and the rail carriages involves the cranes getting connected up first. Then they have to separate the locomotive from the carriage.
Australian Rail Track Corporation contractors have pored over the site for days, constructing a ballast for heavy machinery and analysing the damaged cars.
This is a complex recovery and then repair operation. And once that's taken place, we'll have a better sense of the repair effort required.
The Rail, Tram and Bus Union inspecting the site for the first time.
Insiders refer to it as the goat track because it's bumpy, there's mud holes, there's often issues on this section of track. The fact that it's taken so long to fix up these issues is abhorrent.
It claims some drivers refused to navigate the section of track which was under construction and is calling for a more streamlined approach between state and federal rails.
We want to make sure that the politicians actually see this awful disaster as a wake-up call and they actually come forward with proper funding.
Are you confident that section of track was operating and maintained to an adequate level, to a safe level?
Look, again, I'm not in a position to be able to speculate. It's just so important that we let the safety regulators do their work.
Alicia, we know the initial report into the crash is due within the next 30 days. Here on the ground, though, that recovered locomotive and carriage will start tracking north towards Sydney sometime tomorrow. From there, it will enter a maintenance facility and be inspected by staff from Transport New South Wales. Meanwhile, the carriages here remaining in Wallen will then be removed within the next 48 hours and placed onto trucks and taken back to Sydney. Alicia, here on the ground,